Hi guys, I'm Paul from Beginner Guitar Academy and welcome to another episode of Learn Guitar with Paul. And this episode, we are going to look at picking. Now, I have looked at picking in a couple of episodes and we looked at down-up picking on one single string and we looked at down-up picking on two different strings. So we're going to dive in and look at a new picking exercise for that. Now, picking can be seen as a bit of a boring skill, but as I said way back, I think in the first video we looked at, it's probably one of the most important ones because the right hand really is the engine. It's going to drive your playing. It's going to drive that left hand. The most biggest problem most people fall into, or trap most people fall into, beginner guitarists, is they don't work enough on their right hand. They don't build out that coordination enough. So when they then bring in the left hand, the coordination is not there. So they hit missing strings, not hitting what they want to be hitting. And they're forever then having to look back at the right hand and kind of looking like they're watching tennis, going backs and forwards. So the idea here is we want to get our right hand up to a really good level so we don't have to look at it. So you can pick strings, you know you're going to be picking the one you want to be picking because you've worked so hard on this hand. That's the idea. Also, with the picking exercise we're looking at, what we've basically done is taken the most important picking exercise there are and distilled them into five different picking patterns. So the idea is if you can really get these down, you can really blitz these different picking patterns, they're going to top everywhere in so many different songs. So you could, for instance, take a song like Walk This Way. And if we look at the picking pattern I'm doing there, I'm doing down up along the A string, and then a down on the A up on the D. So that's picking exercise one and picking exercise two. Two of the picking exercise we've already looked at. So the idea is, when you come to learn that song, you think, hold on a minute, I've already done those picking patterns. Right hand just sinks into the groove because it's already practiced it. You know, you've already built the kind of automaticity up. You've brought that kind of habitual playing of the right hand. So you don't think about it. Your right hand just goes, oh, that's picking exercise one, that's picking exercise two, I can rock that. That's where we want to get to. So that's the point of doing this. Again, it can seem a little bit boring rather than kind of diving straight into songs, but it's these fundamental skills that are going to make us basically better guitar players. So it's worth spending time with them. With that in mind, we're going to look at picking exercise number three. So again, to recap, picking exercise one was alternate picking. So down and up on one string, alternating directions, down followed by the up. Picking exercise two was outside picking. So you're picking the outside of two strings, picking the outside of string six, then the outside of string five. What we're going to look at today is inside picking. So you're picking up on the E string and then down on the A string. So you're in between the strings, you're kind of bouncing between the two. Now this is normally one of the ones that most people find troublesome because you need to have obviously accuracy to be able to jump between those two strings, kind of bounce between the two strings. And like before, we want to double check our techniques and make sure you've got a finger on the guitar, so you're bracing. Make sure it's nice and steady as you're picking. You don't want some big strokes in the pick because it's just going to take longer then to return back to the string to do the next pick. We want to keep the pick strokes nice and shallow. And again, it's all about smoothness. So we want it nice and steady in regard to the rhythm and nice and steady in regard to the volume. We do a big hit, small hit, big hit, nice and even. And that is the goal. So we'll be going one, two, three, four, one, two. So maybe two bars, eight picks. Then we're going to drop down onto the D and the, A and the D string, then D and the G string. Forgot what I was picking. And then we drop again, so G and the B. And then finally the B and the E. So all the way down, pairing off the strings like that, for eight picks, so a couple of bars in each one. That gives you a lot of time then to really work that and on to the next pair. And that is the idea for this week. So picking exercise three, be really mindful of your technique. Make sure we're bracing. Make sure we have that pick at 90 degree angle and that the pick is not coming too far away from the strings. Try to keep everything nice and close. Again, we want to program this in, this good technique from the beginning. So it's, you know, we can just keep building on top of that. We're not going to have to get a certain way down, demolish it and start again. We want to have this, you know, strong foundation from the start. And there we go. That is picking exercise number three. Hope you've enjoyed this one, guys. Don't forget to like the page if you are on Facebook, or subscribe and hit the notification bell if you're on YouTube. And keep your eyes open for tomorrow for another video.